So the viral Omah girl has responded to her embarrassing her boyfriend at this concert. And we're going to get to her response. But if you haven't seen this ridiculous Keke Palmer-esque moment, let's check it out right here. I mean, Keke Palmer who? Like, she done took disrespect to a whole nother level. Like, right, what is she? I'm glad her homegirl told her the truth, because at first I heard her say, oh, it wasn't that bad. But then she said, no, it was that bad. Like, you was wilding. And then my man laughing at him like, it's always funny until it's you, till it's your turn. You know what I'm saying? Because we all done been there. And you looking like a simpleton because you done picked a chick from the gutter, a gutter ball, you know what I'm saying, from the streets that was waiting on her time to do what she been itching to do all the time. Like, you know what I'm saying? All it takes is the right dude to bring it up out of.
Bro really invited a female fan from the front row to join him on stage while she was standing right in front of her boyfriend. This is such a crazy situation. She really came with her boyfriend to the concert, gotta be in the front row, and dipped on him right when she had the chance. Omah responded to the situation saying, I asked her if she came alone and she confidently said yes. She told me to feel free. If I had the slightest idea that her boyfriend was present, I would have picked another girl. I can smell cap. If you watch the video, bro literally is standing there with his hands on her hip.
Bro, I don't know. I think he lying on this one. Like, it's clear that she said do whatever because of her actions. But I think it was also clear that old boy was standing there hugged up with her when you pointed to her. So I don't know. Maybe he seen him. Maybe he didn't. But people like Usher and this dude, they just agents of chaos. Like, they would rather steal your girl than to get with one of the millions of single chicks out here. But if she went like she would, like this chick went, she ain't your girl. They was dating for a year. But regardless how she went, she was never your girl, bro. But it's just a hard lesson that we learn when we dealing with these thought boxes out here. And we see the signs that they are that, but we kind of ignore them. You know what I'm saying? Or sometimes you don't see the signs and it displays itself in a moment like this. But let's hear what this chick had to say about this whole situation.
Hi, everyone. I thought it was going to be a story time. I tell my side of the story because the amount of hate that I'm getting called all types of things that I've never even heard before. Like, it's getting a bit scary, and I keep coming, like, whoa. So, I really want to explain myself and address a few rumors as well. But obviously, before I get started, I want to publicly apologize to him. Obviously, me and him, we've had private conversations where we spoke, but since it was public, I think the right thing for me to do is to publicly apologize to him. Like, that was bad, but, you know, it was honestly a mistake. If I knew this would, like, get this far, I wouldn't even go to a concert. I don't know, because this is not worth the hate I'm receiving. But yeah, since it was public, I want to publicly apologize to him. So yeah, let's just get straight into like the story. And the rumors, actually, I want to address the rumors first. So why am I here? Okay, first of all, who's Fafa? No, who's that person? Whoever said that my name was Fafa, can you come? No, come, please. Because how? I literally went on stage. I literally said my name is Jess. I said it twice. So I don't know how people are getting this information from. That's not my name, please. Like, no. And also, people saying that he's the one that bought the tickets. Who told you that as well? Who said he's the one that bought the tickets? It was me. I'm the one that bought the tickets. I wouldn't mean him to have a good time because, you know, like, we're young. Like, real young. So, like, I thought this is a good thing to do. Let me just take that man to a concert. Let's have fun. Like, that's it. There's nothing wrong with that. Like, since when is it illegal to do so? Since when? That just tells you a lot because us women, we can do things as well. Like, if I want to take my man out, I'll take my man out. So...
Keep how fake she is with this explanation. She's going to explain later in this clip that Omah is her favorite artist. She never says that he's her boyfriend's favorite artist.
So obviously, I just got really excited because Omah is like one of my favorite artists. I don't care what anybody says. Like, you all have favorite artists. I didn't want to hear that. Like, so he's mine.
So if your whole thing was you want to take your man out, why are you taking him to see your favorite artist? Why would you not take him to see his favorite artist? See, that's just the cover story to make herself look good. She's like, oh, she gonna take her man out to treat him. But really, it's just low-key a reason for her to go to the concert and ogle over this dude on stage. She didn't know she was going to get picked. I guarantee you, if she had known she would get picked in the front row, she wouldn't have took him at all. Because that would have gave her the opportunity that she wanted to go up on stage and get dry humped like she did. But then that would have gave her the opportunity to take it further, right? Because she would have definitely went home and did anything with old dude if old boy wasn't there with her. We see how far she went when he was there.
So yeah, like I said, it was me. Anyways, also, me and him, like, we've had private conversations about going on stage with Omah because he does this at his shows. If you really know Omah, you will know that he's done this in his past, at his past concerts. Like, this is what he does. This is literally what he does. Like, it's nothing new.
Yeah, so that makes this, like, exponentially worse. Like, it wasn't like she was surprised and she was just overwhelmed and she just did too much. Like, no, she was fully prepared and knew what was going to happen to the T. She had seen it 1,000 times from watching his shows. And she still went up on stage and took it that far. That's crazy.
So, obviously, I said, being at him at this conversation, like, I said to him, if I was to get called on stage, I'm going to go on stage. And he said, that's fine. Like, he's been saying that's fine. Like, me and him never, ever, ever had an issue with me going on stage, even when the time came. Like, I think there was a video where people were saying, like, I was moving away from him, like, I was pushing him away, like, no. Like, Omah literally looked at me and said, he said, I want you. This
I mean, I think he was cool with you going up on stage. He's trying to give you some leeway. He understands this is your favorite artist. He don't want to take away from your moment if you have a moment at the concert. So he like, yeah, do your thing. But I think he thought he may not have specified this. And that's a lesson in of itself. Like, fellas, we got to speak up about how we feel about this type of stuff so your woman know what lines not to cross. Some men would prefer that they lady not even go up on stage. You remember when Usher tried to serenade Saweetie, which was YG's girl at the time? She like, nah, serenade from over there. Give me a little space. And she barely would even sing along with him, you know? Winnie Harlow got called out. She sat on her dude's lap like, nah, we good over here. But this is because those couples clearly talked about that Usher and Keke Palmer situation. But in this case, but he thought it was some unspoken rules that anyone would understand if you were in a relationship. Like, don't go up there and go that far. Like, you went way too far. You got me looking stupid out here. Why would you do that? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I understand you go on stage, you do some little hands-off type of, okay, like, stay, give me some space, serenation or whatever. But you didn't have to go that far. You know what I'm saying? And I think that's what she missed. Or I think she was glad that he never specified that, because she was always going to have full intentions on going 100 miles an hour when she got on that stage with, when and if she got on the stage with Omah.
So, obviously, I just got really excited because Omah is, like, one of my favorite artists. I don't care what anybody says, like, you all have favorite artists. I didn't want to hear that. Like, so he's mine. So obviously he's my favorite artist, not mine. So obviously I got really excited. I was just genuinely happy. And obviously when I moved to the side, that was when he asked me to go on stage. I was just waiting for obviously the security to get me out of the crowd. That's why I was even stood there.
So she says she it was a mistake and she just went too far and this thing. And listen, we've all been there where, you know, most of us where we've been in a relationship and either flirted too hard, being disrespectful or whatever, or texting too hard or whatever, or actually cheated. Like, we done now made mistakes, and you can come back from mistakes if you ask for forgiveness, if you really mean it. But it's a difference between, like, making a mistake and cheating and then having full intentions on cheating when given the opportunity, right? You could be in a relationship with somebody for 3 years, 5 years, and be a perfectly faithful and good woman and all of that, but you're just waiting on this one dude to get at you. And as soon as he get at you, like, you all over it. I mean, that's very different from making a mistake. So that's the difference. Being real with yourself about which one of those categories you fall in. We already know what category she fall in with her and her thought boxery. But it's your boy P-Cam. Let me know what you think, what you don't think. Get at your boy.